Ladies and gentlemen, the following feature confrontation, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Huntsville, Alabama, weighing 233 pounds, beautiful Bobby!
Alright, beautiful Bobby, coming to the ring in our feature event from Disney MGM, New York City Street, as we go back to Gary Capetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in this one-fall contest, he's from Charlotte, North Carolina. He weighs 237 pounds. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat!
You know, Steamboat better be careful, Tony Schiavone. There's fire ordinances here on the streets of New York.
You're right. You're right there, Jesse Ventura. Okay, we've heard the comments from Hulk Hogan, who said he's going to leave it up to the fans. He wants the Hulkamaniacs to unite to call the WCW Wrestling Hotline and vote yes or vote no.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard of in my life.
Why do you say that?
Why? Because it's got to come from him. He's the one that needs the motivation. He should be the one making the decision. Instead, he's going to pass the buck off to the fans.
Yeah, I guess that's what he's going to do. I don't think you should call it pass the buck. We are talking about the man who has always had his career driven by the fans, who has always wrestled for the Hulkamaniacs, the greatest superstar in our sport, and was asked by Mean Gene, are you going to wrestle Ric Flair? He said, it's up to the Hulkamaniacs. That's just his way, and that's why he is Hulk Hogan.
Well, I'll tell you what, he better get more focus. That's why he's Hulk Hogan. That's right.
From the neutral position now. Backing away, beautiful Bobby. Beautiful Bobby, tremendous tag team wrestler. We say it so many times when he's in the ring, but that is true. Now the member of the new tag team, he and Steve Kern, bad attitude, and of course Steamboat has come very close recently to becoming the WCW World Champion.
Steamboat trying to power his way out. That's the strength here now with both men holding top wrist locks.
Over the top, Steamboat. Full arm dragon twist into the Greco-Roman knuckle lock.
And then applying the pressure on the wrist and the fingers right there. Beautiful Bobby got to do something to ease that pressure.
Bobby, a foot to the gut.
That'll ease the pressure. Steamboat returns the favor.
Think about Steamboat. Look at this. Steamboat walking up on Bobby and sending Bobby. Yeah. The Dragon drives the knee in. And fans, I'm told we have to take a break. The tape machines are rolling. If the match ends during the break, we'll show you what happened. If not, more on Worldwide right after this. Timeout. Tony Schiavone, Jesse the Body Ventura, back with you here on WCW Worldwide. Steamboat has continued during our break to hang on to the arm of beautiful Bobby, who's been trying to get away here, Jesse.
Bobby's had one heck of a time. There he finally throws him off and gets a big shoulder in the effort. Block on the hip toss. Another block on the hip toss. Both guys counter wrestling very well. Fireman's carry over the top, back to the arm, Tony.
Steamboat has remained very focused, and that's been one of his strong points during his career. You take a look at our great crowd. What a great time we've had here at Disney. We always have a great time.
So now, like, did they pass out ballots to all the people here at Disney, whether they're going to vote yes or no on Hogan? I haven't got one yet.
Well, we might as well know what you're going to vote for. You and Bobby the Brain Heenan are just about the same.
I'm voting yes.
You're voting yes?
Yeah. I don't think he's in shape. I think he'll come back and get beat. I'd love to see it.
Yeah, you're wrong.
Voting yes. I want him back. In fact, I may vote more than once.
Well, I'm sure you will. A knee.
Little bit of clipping right there from behind. Little shoulder arm action, and Steamboat holding onto that leg. He's hurting, Tony.
Beautiful Bobby. Sure. Twisting on the leg, but Steamboat kicks away. Ricky Steamboat back to his feet. An arm drag kick down again. Being very content with keeping Bobby, who is a high flyer, off his feet. Bobby Lee and Steamboat are very similar in many ways. They're both high flyers. They both have great endurance. They both are veterans, former champions.
And either man can beat the other one on any given night.
That's right. And can beat anyone in WCW any given night. There's a single leg takedown. Kind of a version of the drop toe hold. And he grapevines the legs, does beautiful Bobby. Steamboat trying to just pull Bobby away from it. Jimmy Jett, the referee, checks in. One, only.
Beautiful Bobby applying pressure down low on that knee of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Steamboat trying to grab, face lock him back a little bit. Bobby applies the pressure and back up to a kneeling position.
We got a two that time out of it. And Bobby almost has the legs, almost like a figure four almost, without having the other leg over top the one.
If I was Steamboat, I'd pull the hair right now. That's how you get out of it.
Oh, I know. I know that's how Jesse the Body would get out of it.
Better laying there and taking the pressure. Don't you think?
Well, the fans probably don't think. Good to have you with us.
Very profound. You're right. The fans don't think.
Yeah, there you go. Once again, Bobby has that leg grapevined, and he has the pressure down on the left knee of Ricky Steamboat here, and really know where Steamboat can go. So he's trying to get out. Finally, back up to one leg. Bobby, he set himself up for that one. Steamboat kicked him. And Bobby falls on it. Two count. Bobby got the balance, got the leverage going his way. He's going to hook a leg. He's back to a leg. He's keeping Steamboat grounded here.
And Steamboat should have known better on that move, I think, Tony. He'd had the leg worked over, not up to full strength. You better have both wheels underneath you if you think you're going to pick somebody up and body slam them.
Two count.
And I got a feeling that Steamboat's a little off his game plan here. I don't believe he felt beautiful Bobby would take him down and do mat wrestling. It's a little out of the ordinary for beautiful Bobby. Not that he's not capable of doing it, but it is not his forte. And I think he's caught Steamboat a little off guard here.
It's a good point. As Steamboat trying his best to get out of it without pulling the hair, but he's close to the ropes there. He can reach the ropes to get the break. There
That's
he goes.
A cheap way out.
Better than pulling the hair.
Why? At least you have to pull the hair hard. All you gotta do is throw your leg over the rope.
A hand to the face, single leg pickup again by beautiful Bobby. He's going for a figure four here, possibly. Steamboat, though, shoots him out with a foot to the rear end.
Head first into the buckle. Steamboat trying to walk it off. Big chop.
The Irish whip to the left side. And he puts Steamboat down to the mat. But Steamboat back up. Oh, Bobby's laying him in now. One of the greatest right hands of the sport, beautiful Bobby. Oh, that sounded like a hand hitting the trash can. Oh, that was somebody hitting the trash can over here on the right. A pickup and a belly to back. Steamboat may go for the top here. He is not 100%. Remember, beautiful Bobby has focused on the legs, but Bobby doesn't see it. And the fans are standing. And Bobby is not.
Got him.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
And as you watch worldwide and you think about yes or no on the WCW Wrestling Hotline, should Hulk Hogan wrestle Ric Flair? It's up to you, the fans. Steamboat comes away with a great win.
Let's go back to replay. There's Steamboat with a good belly-to-back suplex right there. That broke beautiful Bobby. The big crossbody off the top. Hooks the leg, gets the three count, Tony.
We'll be back with another look at Worldwide.